fictitious online conspiracy theory. But 28-year-old Edgar Madison Welch of North Carolina, he walked into a restaurant full of customers yesterday, fired the weapon, according to police, and pointed it at an employee. No one, thankfully, was injured. Welch was arrested and charged with assault with a dangerous weapon. Two firearms were found in the restaurant. Another was found in his car. Now, my next guest was one of the customers in the restaurant during this entire scary incident. Sharif Silmi is joining me right now. Mr. Silmi, thank you so much for joining me. You were in the restaurant with your wife and your three young kids. Can you tell me what you saw?
Yeah, so we were in the restaurant and the middle section of the restaurant where there's some ping pong tables and foosball tables. My family was playing. I was actually playing ping pong with my wife at the time. And the suspect walked in. He walked behind me. I assumed he was a security guard. Several people seen him with the gun. And we're obviously, you know, starting to kind of move around and shake things up. And so a employee came and grabbed me and let me know that this was indeed somebody that wasn't supposed to be there and was a gunman. And obviously my first reaction was to get my family out and, you know, get my kids out. And my wife did the same. And thankfully we're out of there. The staff there did an amazing job getting everyone out. It was a very swift exit for all the patrons. Nobody seemed really like nervous or anything. Everybody swiftly left the place. We went out to the sidewalk and then proceeded across the street into a restaurant where we were, you know, safer.
What did he seem like? What was his demeanor? What in the brief time that you kind of you saw him, was he calm? Was he agitated? Did you get any sense?
He was. It seemed that he was headed straight for the back room. That's why my thought was that he was a staff member, because he was walking with straight into the back room. He didn't engage with me or any other patron. I didn't see him engage with any other customers or staff. He just walked straight into the back.
What was the reaction of everyone else in the restaurant? You said that everyone kind of got out calmly and swiftly. I mean, whenever someone would walk into a restaurant with a gun, it seems difficult that everyone would be able to get out calmly, I guess.
It was rather remarkable, I think, that we were probably the last family to leave, because, like I said, we were kind of in the back, you know, in the ping pong area.
Right.
And the people, so the people in front of us were all moving, you know, very swiftly and calmly, and we were all out. You know, a couple, like the cooks I seen running kind of, you know, fast out of there, so that kind of shook things up a little bit. But for the most part, people were, you know, very calm. We were to be, you know, we were aware of the sort of, you know, controversy around the place. And frankly, the lies that have been propagated regarding the Comet ping pong. But it's not going to deter us from visiting it. It's a delicious pizzeria. It's an excellent place to go. We had a blast, you know, playing ping pong. And, you know, we're not going to be, you know, frightened by people's lies. You know, people like Alex Jones out there that are lying and manipulating people and, you know, are really, in my opinion, and I tweeted this out, responsible for the danger that my family was in yesterday.
You are responsible. You also, I assume, hold this guy responsible who on his own free will came into this restaurant with a gun.
Yeah, obviously he's directly responsible, but in my opinion, the folks like Alex Jones and others that are propagating these lies have some responsibility for these folks' actions, because they're pouring fuel on the fire.
What have you told your young children since this whole thing?
You know, we're Muslim Americans, and we're basically see ourselves being demonized, frankly, in the media and online and all over the place. So I always let them know that, you know, we need to be vigilant and aware of potential threats around us. And, you know, this obviously was a manifestation of that, but, you know, thankfully nobody was hurt. They were all very calm and, you know, very very cool about it, surprisingly, and, you know, I was really proud of them. In fact, you know, on our way home, I live in Maryland, we were driving up to Maryland, I said, you know, what do you guys think? You guys want to go home or you want to go see a movie? And they said, no, let's go see a movie. And we went to a movie theater and watched a movie and, you know, didn't let it ruin our life or interfere with what we do and how we behave. I mean, we're out there and we're not going to be scared by people.
Well, and as you very well said, thankfully no one was injured. And thanks so much for coming on and speaking with us. We appreciate it.
My pleasure.